This is a video on introduction to carbohydrates and the isomerism. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please click on the subscribe button below and do subscribe to the channel. If you like our work, please share it with your friends. So let's get started. So what is carbohydrate? Carbohydrate is polyhydroxyaldehydes and ketones. The name the carbohydrate, the name itself tells you many things. That's carbo. It means it contains a carbon, and hydrate means it contains a water. So CH2O is the molecular or the empirical formula of the carbohydrate, where N denotes the number of carbon atoms. If you multiply the CH2O by the number of carbon atoms, such as in glucose, if you multiply 6, you get C6H12O6, which is the formula for the structural formula. Sorry, the molecular formula of glucose. So what is the definition of carbohydrate? Carbohydrate are polyhydroxyaldehydes and ketones. Now we'll focus on this all these three words separately. That's polyhydroxy, what is aldehydes, and ketones, what they are signifying. So first start with the poly. What do you mean by polyhydroxy? It means it contains many hydroxy group or the OH group. When any substance contains an OH group, it means it is polar and it has a tendency to bind phosphate. This property I have also told you in the hydroxy containing amino acids. So if you want to watch the video, you can go on a video section and watch about the classification of the amino acids. There you can get the about the tendency to bind phosphate. I have also mentioned in the amino acids video. So whenever you see hydroxyl group, it means it is polar, so the compound is polar and has a tendency to bind phosphate. This is a property of hydroxyl. So whenever glucose enter inside a cell, suppose it is entering inside a cell, it gets converted into glucose 6-phosphate. So whenever glucose enters inside the cell, it gets immediately converted into glucose 6-phosphate because it has a tendency to bind phosphate because of the hydroxyl group present in the carbohydrate. So now I will tell this property which is specific to carbohydrate only. Don't mix it with any other compound. It is specific to carbohydrate only. In case of carbohydrate, number of hydroxyl group is 1 less than the number of carbon atoms. Suppose we take the example of glucose, in which there are 6 carbon atoms. So number of hydroxyl group will be 1 less than number of carbon. So number of hydroxyl group in glucose is 5. What does aldehydes and ketones signify? These are the functional groups present in the carbohydrates. Some carbohydrates have aldehyde as a functional group, while others have ketones as a functional group. Here you can see example of a 3 carbon carbohydrate which contains a aldehyde group. Aldehyde is present in the terminal carbon, while the keto group is present on the center carbon. Not exactly center, but not terminal. It can be another carbon than the terminal carbons. So this is the example of carbohydrate with the keto group, and this is the carbohydrate with the aldehyde group. Now we proceed on further with the isomerism. We will see its types and what are the examples we see in the different cases of the classes of isomerism. We will study isomerism under two topics. That is, it is divided into two parts: structure of the stereoisomer and the optical isomerism. It usually generates through the asymmetric carbon atom present in the carbohydrates. Suppose, what do you mean by asymmetric carbon atoms? When a carbon is attached to 3 different groups, then the carbon becomes asymmetric. When what to say about this? C double bond O, with one side CHO, other side CH2OH. What do you say about this carbon? Whether it is symmetric or asymmetric? It is symmetric because 2 bonds are attached to oxygen. So C double bond O is also example of symmetric carbon. In structural isomerism, we have functional isomerism, enantiomerism, epimerism, and anomerism. So all these four types come under structural isomerism. What is isomer? See, suppose you take glucose and fructose. What is the formula of glucose? C6H12O6. And what is the formula of fructose? C6H12O6. So there is a difference in the structure. So it is called isomerism. Same formula but difference in structure or the position of the different atoms. So we have structural isomerism, which there we have function, enantiomerism, epimerism and anomerism. In functional isomerism, we have different functional groups. So write what we have. Isomerism divided into two categories, structural and optical. Optical will proceed on further after the we'll discuss all the structural isomerism. So for starting with this functional, functional isomerism, we have different functional group. I told you what was the definition of carbohydrate, polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones. So only mainly two groups are, two functional groups are present in the carbohydrate that are one aldehyde group, other keto group. So depending on the aldehyde and keto group, we have different types of carbohydrates which are functional isomer of each other. Before proceeding further, let us discuss some basic 3-carbon aldehyde and 3-carbon keto compound or the keto carbohydrate. So I will tell you the how to write the structure of a any carbohydrate. First write down the number of carbon atoms. So it is C1, C2, C3 and first it is 3-carbon aldehyde type of carbohydrate. So make the aldehyde group at the terminal carbon or the first carbon and the CH2OH group on the last carbon. So whenever you have to make the structure of any carbohydrate, at the first you write down the number of carbon atoms. Like in case we have 3 here, so C1, C2, C3, then for the write down the functional group. In this case it is aldehyde, so you have CHO here, and in the last carbon make CH2OH. In all other carbons make OH on the right side and H on the left side. Now see in the case of keto, 3-carbon keto, first I told you write the functional group. Keto is present not at the terminal, so in this case it is present in the second carbon atom. On the we wrote down number total number of carbon, it was 3. Then we wrote down the functional group. Then at last carbon we wrote CH2OH. This is called chrysaldehyde. It is a 3-carbon aldehyde and it is called dihydroxyacetone. Now in the functional isomerism, we see the example of glucose and fructose. In both glucose and fructose, we have 6 carbons. That is, it is a hexose. So we wrote down the number of carbon atoms C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6 in both the glucose and fructose. In case glucose was C1, C2, C3, C4, C5 and C6. So what was the first thing was write the number of carbon atoms that we wrote down. Now second thing was write the functional group. In this case it is aldehyde, in case of glucose, and in case of fructose it is keto group. Now the third thing was to write down the OH on the right and H on the left. So you wrote down OH on the second carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon, but not in the third carbon. In the third carbon we have OH on the left side. Same is in the case of fructose. In third carbon we have OH on the left side. So remember that in all other carbon atoms except the first and the last, we have to write OH on the right. Except the third carbon, we have a C3 where we have to write OH on the left side in case of both glucose and fructose. In glucose we have 6 carbon, so we wrote down the number of carbon atoms 1, 2, 3, 4, we made 5 here and 6 here. We wrote down the functional group C11O, then at last terminal carbon CH2OH, and all other carbons OH on the right, except the third carbon in which OH is on the left. So this was all about the functional isomerism.